Greetings, beautiful people, and welcome to the channel for another video of how you should downgrade Skyrim to enable mods and modding in general. If you want more of those helpful type of videos, let me know by liking, subscribing, or commenting down below. It helps me find my audience. Thank you for your time. Let's begin with the basics. Skyrim has three versions. The latest version, aka the Anniversary Edition, the Skyrim Special Edition 1.597, the 1.6640. You might say, Kavou, why use this one? This one is in the middle of the oldest version and the latest version, so it has some of the good things Bethesda has done when it comes to bug fixes, and it also has support for the Creation Club. It's a weird middle of the pack. In my opinion, I would rather go again for the Special Edition 1.597 or the Anniversary Edition. Anniversary Edition, aka the latest version, it works with all of the Creation Club content you might have, and it's mostly used, in my opinion, if you want to have a lightweight mod list. Maybe you want to put 30 and 50 mods and just play mostly vanilla Skyrim. This is your version to go. And then the 1.597, it's the version that you should use if you want to put way too many mods into your game. Almost every single mod on the Nexus supports the 1.597. Not all mods work for the latest versions. First of all, you need a fresh installment of Skyrim to do this properly. I haven't done this because I am working on a mod list for the next video. That being said, it is extremely simple. You just open Steam, go to your Skyrim, go to manage, you uninstall the game, and when you uninstall it, you pretty much install it again. And that's how simple it is. You have a fresh installment of Skyrim. After you manage installing Skyrim, you want to click play over here. And the reason for that is, you want to have the ini files be generated, which you will not be able to mod or do any of that without this. And when you click play, you won't see this on my game, but on your game, if you fresh install Skyrim, you will get a pop window on the menu screen downloading the Creation Club content, which you should do. The only reason you are not going to see this here on this video is again because my game is already modded. That being out of the question, once you're done with this, when you finish downloading all of your Creation Club shenanigans, scroll down, click quit, and leave the game. Here comes the important part. You're going to find out how to check what version you have. Right click to your Skyrim, go to manage, and go to browse local files. You're going to find where your Skyrim EXE is, right click on it, go to properties, and go to details, and here you see which version of Skyrim you have. This is important because, for example, if let's say you want to install a mod for Skyrim, and I'm picking address library for example, and you go to files, you see here you have 1.597 version, and this is for the latest version, 1.6.1130+. So it's very important to know which version you have, because anytime you are going to install a mod, you're going to grab the version that works for this version of the game. The next thing you want to do, you want to press the Windows key and the R key. When you do that, this thingy majiggy on the bottom will pop. And you want to run this command right here. I will have it down in the video description, and click OK. This is going to open this window, which don't be scared about it. We're going to downgrade your game. To downgrade our game, we're going to install a bunch of files through Steam to downgrade the game. Let's start by downgrading to the Special Edition. You want to click over here and copy paste the text I will have down in the video description, so we can start downloading those files. For example, I'm inserting the first file here, and you're gonna press Enter. You see over here, this will start downloading. There is a total of 3 files for any time you want to downgrade your game, so we can put all of them together, and the game is going to download those. It is going to take a while, guys, so grab a coffee, eat a sweet roll or two, and come back once this process will finish. You will get a pop-up message telling you that the process has finished.
6.5 hours later.
All of our files have been generated. If you want to downgrade your game to any other version, let's say 1.6, 640, I will have all of that stuff in the description. Copy this by clicking Ctrl C, and as you can see, this is on my E driver. I'm gonna go on the E driver, and I'm going to copy paste by pressing Ctrl V this, and it's going to give me those three files, which is the files we have installed. Again, the process is the exact same for any version of Skyrim you wish to downgrade. Let's open our Skyrim folder. If you don't know where your Skyrim folder is, right click on Skyrim on Steam, go to Manage and go to Browse. Your files will look way more different than mine, because as you can see, this is a modded version. I have ENB, I have all of that, but the process remains the exact same. Have those two windows, the windows where we have the files we want to downgrade on the left side of your screen, and have your Skyrim folder on the other, because we're going to cook. You need to click those files and open them one by one, starting from the bottom, and you're going to grab everything and drag and drop it inside where your Skyrim is. I am not going to do that because my Skyrim is already modded. Once you finish with the first file, click the middle file, select everything, and drag and drop it where your Skyrim is again. And when this process is finished, go back, grab the latest one, and drop this where your Skyrim is. You will be able to go to your Skyrim after this process is done, go to Properties, go to Details, and your Skyrim will have changed to the downgraded version we have. The only reason you see me having the latest one is because that's the version I am using. Have I done all of those things on the video? I will have right now 1.597, and so would you. This is how simple downgrading your game is, and if you're new to Skyrim and modding, I get that this can be a little bit of a wall to climb. Now, something also very important that we want to do is that we want to stop the automated patches. I've been modding Skyrim, guys, for more than 10 years, and I'm telling you, there will be a day that will come where Skyrim will get a new version, and all of the previous versions, all of your mods, it will be impossible to play, and this happens so many times, so you want to avoid that, and this is how we do this. We go to our Skyrim again, we go to Manage, and we click Browse Local Files, and you want to go where the Steam Apps is. So you see where my cursor is, click the Steam App so we can go all the way back, and we're going to find the app Manifest 480, 9080, this crap over here, specifically this one. So again, I will have this down in the video description, and you want to right click on this crap, go to Properties, and select the read only, click Apply, click OK, and that's it. We are pretty much done. That means now you know how to downgrade your game to any version you want. Have in mind if you like to play on the latest version of Skyrim, because maybe you're like me, you're lazy, and you mostly like to play vanilla Skyrim. But if you want to downgrade your game, which I like to do occasionally, now you know how to do it. And also you know how to stop the patches from destroying your game anytime you're going to click play. Those two things are extremely important when you start modding your game, because guys, you have no idea how many times I've spent hundreds of hours working for 2 and 3 weeks creating the perfect mod list only for Todd Howard and Bethesda to drop a new stupid update for the Creation Club that would make my mod list pretty much useless. So we're stopping that by cancelling the automated updates, which we have done. Thank you for watching these videos. If you like more guides, more boring videos like those, feel free to let me know down in the comment section by writing so. And thank you so much for watching. Your support means a lot to me. It's me, Kavou. I cover other games than Skyrim. Let me know if you want to watch anything else, and feel free to ask me anything down in the comment section. I will see you up until the next time, and until then, happy modding.